Dr. Delcor, let's talk about common objection to the Trinity. One common objection I'm sure you hear, and I want to know how you would answer this. The objector says, look, Jesus didn't even know when he was coming back. He obviously, and we know that God knows everything. God is omniscient. Jesus is not omniscient. He didn't know. Therefore, Jesus is not God. How would you answer that?
Yeah, they would always appeal to this passage in Mark 13 about he doesn't know when he's coming back. First, the glaring error is that, again, Mark has a Christ that is God in the flesh. Mark 14, 62, and Mark 6, 50, when he claims I am. So Mark's not changing his doctrine. But this one, he doesn't know when he's coming back. First, there is an ascending order of being, right? No man knows man. No angels know angel. What is the higher category of being above angels? God, right? There's no other. He right. says, not even the Son of Man. So even from the start, it asserts the deity, you know. But how does this, you know, what does he mean? I don't know. Well, simply, and I know we don't have a lot of time, but interestingly, the verb to know, eido, can take the force of, I'm not going to get technical, but the Hebrew causative stem or verb of causality or declaration. In other words, in 1 Corinthians 2:2, we have the same verb being used in a declaratory sense. I determine, says Paul, to declare or decide to know nothing among you but Jesus Christ, to him crucified. He declares something. Mm-hmm. So in that sense, taking the Hebrew hyphal stem of cause and or declaration, we can read this passage like this. But of the day of the hour, none will make known or cause you to know except the Father alone. The angels won't cause you to know. The man can't cause you to know, not even the Son of Man, but that privilege is the Father. He's the one that will declare it. So that erases the ignorance of the Son, and Paul used it, that verb, in that very sense.
So it's not that Jesus doesn't know, we could say, but that word, if you could say again for our audience and explain it and its understanding to us one more time.
The verb to know, eido in the Greek, can have the same sense in the Hebrew causative stem of I declare or I make known. Make known.
Right.
So he's saying no one will make known, not that I don't know.
Right, there you
no
go.
One will make known except the Father alone.
Right.
I declare it. And Paul used the same verb in the same sense.
Right, perfect.
I declare.
Perfect. Great answer. Great short answer. Very important topic. But one that I think that all of our Christian brothers and sisters can use. Thank you.